So I'm getting ready to make the bag that I was interfacing earlier. I will be able to see comments because I am logging in on my tablet. And I have all my pieces here ready to go. This bag isn't going to be anything fancy. I'm not adding any what do you call that? Any interior or exterior pockets. It's just going to be a simple backpack. And yeah, so I'm just separating my pieces, my exterior from my interior, because the way this backpack goes together, you kind of need to sew together. Kind of need to sew together. I put a piece. No, that goes with that. That goes there. Okay. Yeah, so you kind of need to sew together the bottom of the bag, both interior and exterior, before you can sew together the zipper gusset. It's a really unique bag. It's designed by Miko Crafts. So I also have just a really simple zipper here. But this is the bag we're making, but we're just making it in a different with different materials without these side pockets, because I shrunk down his original pattern and these side pockets are a little small to actually like put much in. You can like slip like these are like a tiny pair of scissors. You can slip like a keys or something in these side pockets, but not much. So that's what we're working on. And let's get started in a second, because I have not made any bobbins. I'm going to I think I'm gonna use this orange, but I don't like the idea of the top stitching matching perfectly. It'll be fine. Yeah, we're just gonna go ahead with the orange top stitching. I'm just gonna bear with me while I roll a couple bobbins. I don't think I have any empty ones over here. I have one with a little bit of the orange on it, but I'm gonna go ahead and grab a bobbin. Yeah, I'm just gonna roll one. See how far that gets us. Like I said, I do have a little bit of another one. There we go. That's weird. Okay. I see that you can like only see my face, so I moved the camera a little bit. Hopefully that helps. I'm going to work on the interior, switch over to the exterior after. We'll start here. So basically, I'm going to put together this section, put sides on, and then we'll go from there. Okay, let me so I'm just gonna clip this to make it easier to sew together. Just clipping a little bit. Okay. So apparently I'm not paying attention to anything I'm doing. That's bad. It's fine. Started sewing that at a half, and I really want it at a quarter. I don't know why I started sewing that at a half. I am losing my mind. That's fine. Let's just pick these stitches out. Losing my little mind. Okay, starting that over. Okay, let's try that again. Okay. Oh, this is fun. I'm just having all the world's troubles today. This is fun. So as you know, things don't always go right. Another reason I don't like using quilt cotton with this machine, I've found that it tends to like want to eat it instead of sew it, which is odd. It may just be my tension. Could go grab one of my domestics and do it with that, but and then what was I saying? It's really like it doesn't want to freaking do this. This is hella annoying. Oh, I'm an idiot. That's it. I never put my bobbin back in. It's cool. Yeah. I don't know. I guess I haven't gone live in enough. Like, because I'm over here just being weird. And now I have to fix this. Okay. 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 Tries. Third time's the charm, right? Third time is the charm. There we go. Thank you. A little better picture. Got this up, you know. Okay. Thank you. one side done, we're gonna do the other side. Okay. It's right here. I'm like, where's the other one?
Thank you.
Okay, so that's the bottom section of the lining done. And now we're gonna start on the upper portion. All I'm doing right now is marking my centers. Marking my centers. Once again, we're following that same, lining up the centers. And then lining up the ends. Line up the centers and line up the ends. It's not where it should be. Top stitch this down. Okay. We got that part done. This is going to be so cute. Okay. I'm completely out of frame. I'm trying to get more in frame. Just put it on the curve. That in and spread her open. Just slightly. So it's gonna be a little bit tough to get in here. Zero stretches. Okay. I'm not quite getting it to like fully fit in there, but we're gonna see what we can figure out. Thank you. exactly where I wanted it, but that'll do. So far, that's where we're at. We're gonna put on the other side. Okay, I'm probably going to try and reposition the camera in a bit so that you can get a better idea of what I'm doing. I keep going into my lap. I may have flipped these too far in. We'll find out in a bit. Stretched in, stretch. I wish I had a ponytail holder, but I don't. So I'm just gonna fill this up. Was watching a movie. I guess I decided they didn't want to watch. They didn't want me to do that anymore. Okay. I'm using kind of like a combination of putting my hand inside and holding onto the bottom fabric to kind of like get this to properly go together at 1/4 inch and go up the curve. Kind of need to like make sure those spreads are spreading, if that makes sense. Sometimes you can do it by like positioning and pulling the two layers together, which I'm also doing a little bit of, but in order to make sure that this stays where I need it. I'll put that down so I can position this underneath. Move that where I used to be. There we go. Okay. That looks like we're good. Now we're back to the part. I'm gonna sew it. Yeah, it's the way now. Okay. We have the lining, and now it's time for the zipper. I've already gone ahead and added two zipper pulls to my zipper. Now I'm just gonna put it onto the bag. I did not mark the center piece, which is gonna help. I actually need to know the center for this. So now. Okay, so now I have my centers marked. So I have my center marked here. My center, I don't really need it marked on the zipper. But even still, I wouldn't do that because that might cause my zipper to fray. And it looks like I didn't seal my zipper all the way. So I'm going to go ahead and just hit it really quick. Hit it real quick. Okay, just hit it real quick. Okay. I can go ahead and mark the center on this zipper. It's not really necessary, but we'll do it. Okay. So I'm gonna use a chalk pencil real quick. And I'm just gonna fold my zipper in half and mark the center. Fold it in half. Mark it on that side. Mark it on that side. Probably can't see it, but I can. It's marked in the center. Okay. So now I'm just gonna go ahead and pop this Because of it'd help if I did that correctly. Okay. So this is gonna be like this, or something like this. Okay. I'm gonna mark it on here first. So it's gonna get pinched here. This is the center. Because of the unique shape of this bag is the reason I'm not going to just use tape to hold it in place, and I'm actually going to base the zipper in place today, because I normally don't, but you know, just because it has such a unique shape, it's easier to just basted it actually to it instead of using tape. If it was just straight, tape all day, but it's an awkward curved surface. We're just gonna do that probably like an eighth of an inch when we base that down. Okay. It makes sense to put the camera behind me, but okay. So now we have our zipper clipped in place. Now let's pack it down really quick. And then we'll add our lining. We're almost there. With the exception of our back. Give me 1 second. I'm just going to step away because I need some water. Okay, my movie doesn't want to play in here. That's fun. So I guess we're finding something else to intertwine all. Oh, I was still need it over there. Is it frozen? I think we're a little frozen over here. That's fun. That's fun. My tension is all the way off. All the way off. Be really cute. It's gonna be a sack out. Okay, I must find where that center mark is. Sorry, just thought I heard something. I'm coming back. So I'm just flipping this. I'm going to stitch this now at 1/4 inch. Okay, so I'm just gonna flip this into this real quick. I'm gonna stitch this straight. Okay. Careful not to unzip those off. So now we're going to top stitch the zipper. Okay. So. I didn't think it through, but I put the Decaville light all over the panel and I was like, yeah, it'll be fine in my seams. Forgetting that I had it in the zipper panel, which means it's double backed on itself. That's gonna be difficult. So we'll see how that that stitches up, but you know. I'm just gonna clip it on the end because you can't really clip this. Can't really clip it. I'm just gonna clip it on its end. On the end. Okay, so those seams are going to be a little tough, but we're going to get through them. Going to get through them. Okay. Okay. Cool. So now we gotta do the upper zipper panel. Now that we have the lower zipper panel done, we're gonna do the upper zipper panel now. So here's my pieces for my upper panel. And I still think this is like really cute. This is the inside of the bag, but it kind of like almost perfect. Like, this is so cute. It's so cute. On camera, he's looking a little redder, but he's definitely like just straight up orange. But It's still really pretty. It's still really, I'm calling it pretty, but it's actually like, it's really cute. It's really cute. It's really, really, really cute. So, it's really, really cute. Really, really cute. Really, really cute. Like, he's adorable. Okay. So, I have my centers marked on here. I do not have my center marked on this panel. I'm going to go mark it really quick. So, now, I don't know where the center is. We're gonna guess here. Gotta guess. Cause I marked it on the, oh, I see it still on the zipper. I do still see it on the zipper. I lied. So. Making a bunch of noise. That's it. Nothing new. I'm like so confused at what's going on. Okay. Cool. Okay. So I'm gonna, oh, excuse me. So I'm gonna go ahead and base down this zipper on the top. movie. But it's nighttime. Okay. You're not polite to people? How did he know he was there? Did he see him? To confirm what? Because there's like an address. Okay. And so we get an idea of what this is going to look like. Now we're adding on the lining. So now we're going to go ahead and we're going to stitch that down. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and we're going to stitch this down. Okay. So we're going to go at 1/4 inch. Length a little bit just to make sure that this is locked in. Put the zippers down. I'm gonna move the feet. Be very, very careful when I do that. Warm up here. You know it's this light. This freaking light is. So now I can flip that up, and I blanket and cut this piece, the lining, to the top piece here, simply because I knew with like small pieces like this, I knew how like crucial it is that they match up perfectly. And I didn't want that kind of stress in my life, so I'm just gonna pull this out. Okay, I'm gonna pull it out as I stitch it. It's gonna be hard. Flip it inside out. This will make it a little bit easier. Just flip it inside out. Get it underneath the foot. Get it underneath the foot. I'm going to stitch it the same way we did the bottom section. Lengthen our stitch length. Just make sure we don't sew our fingers together, you know? That's it. On here. I'm gonna grab a handmade plate. Okay, so now we have the base of our bag, which is super cute, super cute. Now I gotta decide where my handmade label is gonna go. I'm thinking like right above the black. Because the face isn't perfectly centered, so if I put a name tag on here that is perfectly centered, it's gonna make the bag look off. Because currently right now it doesn't look terrible. I don't know if maybe I should put it like on the top. I don't know. For these curves, I'm gonna go ahead and So, no, I've done that. It's gonna help these lay a little bit better. Because of the... There we go. Okay, now let's get the back ready. So, for the back, we're gonna go, I already have some strapping cut. I haven't picked up the hardware yet, so I need some brass sliders. Some brass sliders. Let's do those. I don't know where. I said I wasn't putting a name tag on this one, didn't I? Let's see something else. I don't know. There's something else I don't know. I'm not sure where I put it. So I need two sliders and two rectangle rings. So I'm just turning two sliders into rectangle rings. Cool. Okay, so and go here. I'm not gonna stitch. After I prepare the back panel, I am going to log off for the evening, and then we'll be done. And I'll show you how far we got. So on this piece. We're just gonna just eyeballing it about here. And so I'm just literally just gonna stitch these to the back of the bag. And then I'm gonna go to bed. Well, no, not bed, but I'm gonna go do something else. So this is fun. Making sure the sides are about right. Okay. Okay. Do this one, and then we're done for the evening. His story right there. Get there? Okay. Perfect. Okay, so what we've accomplished in this session, we got our back started, but not finished. So this is all we have of our back so far. And then we can go ahead and show. And then we have our actual bag. And this is super, super duper adorable. This is very reminiscent of, this is the same look that I got with the Kirby bag, which I can grab really quickly. But this is just a different shape. So, I don't really know where the camera is. So this is where we're at currently. So yeah, so this is gonna be a super adorable backpack, super cute with just like the face on it. I'm just gonna take this down. So we got super adorable bag. It's gonna be so cute. And that's really cute to how I did this one. But the Charmander here is gonna have this shape to it, which is super cute. So I'm just gonna log off for the night, and it was good hanging out. Night.